So right now, it's roll it over. And the gasoline we're using today is non-alcohol.
Cranking!
Ooh. That was a great glob of geeb.
Oh, this is why. I couldn't fit this down into the cylinder, so I used this.
I just came jumping right out of there. Almost looked like water.
Oh, it's gasolina. Wow.
Good thing that coil wire is grounded.
Cranking.
It's still cranking stuff out of there.
Good thing my spark plug's not in there.
Good thing there's lots of oil in there.
Somebody on YouTube did a test to see if compression would change whether it was a wide open throttle or idle. And what they found, there's some more of those stupid text people. What they found was it didn't make any difference in the final. It raises a little bit quicker at wide open throttle, but end result after six hits is the same. So, let's see what we have, shall we?
Number four.
Is it leaking?
Oh, come on.
90? No. It can't be that poor, can it?
Apparently.
Well, 95. Wait a minute. 100. Okay. I'm okay with 100. Not really good for a cylinder that's had oil put in it. This car has set for 7 years. Helps when you take the transmission out of gear. That is at 110. First thing is determine whether or not it's even viable to drive. I hope so, because I already bought it.
I never checked the coolant.
Oh, it's full.
Full is good.
125. If any of you recall the Pontiac engine resurrection, I will not be doing that with this.
Number one.
130. Apparently that gasoline wash did it some good, huh? Let's go back to here again. Well, 90. It's worth running. Didn't check for spark. Ready? Watch right there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Three things make an engine run. Fuel, ignition, and compression. We have adequate compression, we have adequate ignition, and we have adequate fuel. So, and I just tried pushing down on the throttle cable. It ain't happening. That means I gotta pull this carburetor. This makes me very not happy. But, let's see if it'll fire up.
Here we go!
That's all she's got. I'm happy with that. All right, on the next one. See ya. Back to the 59. Ready? Go.
going to go with this one now. Let's try what we've learned, shall we? Screwdriver. Packer. Fry. Another time around, shall we? If I can just get one side off, I can peel the rest. Of course, this one has to be far more difficult than the first one. This one, it appears that the rubber gasket has glued itself to the ring here as well. Are you gonna go yet? Finally. Hey, and our glass came off with it. Alright, I should put this somewhere that I know which one it is. Okay, original. Huh. Isn't that interesting? I had never seen nothing like that before in my life. Maybe this one's fixable. Rubber still has to come off before the face will come out. Oh, I see. There's a piece of metal laminated between the two pieces of rubber. At least this part should work. I wonder what that's all about. This one looks a lot nicer on the inside. Except for that odometer. Do I dig deeper? Little plug there. It looks like a plastic plug there. Metal plug there. Two screws. Apart with the rest of it. Doesn't appear to be doing anything. Oh, that sounded like it did something. Probably ripped the... Why, there's a spring in there. Right there. This one doesn't look all bunched up. So that's what it is. The spring has broken, come off. I can fix something like that. Well, I succeeded in doing something. I succeeded in pulling the shaft up out of the bell. You know what that means. It means I have to do it differently the next time. But how do you press the thing back on? Maybe that's not the way you do it. A little clip here for the shaft, what holds the odometer. think I'll choose my best one of those. What was this one at? 70? I don't remember. I'll have to go look. So put that out of the way. Hey, there's two screws on this. I'm fairly certain this is not the way you do this. But you know, that's the way I'm going to do it. I still can't get it past these screws. I mean, that can't possibly screw off of there, can it? I know what you're saying. Should have tried it on this one first. When I did, I pulled that whole bushing up out of there. Well, see, this is a good one. That's why I don't want to ruin it. I just want to get that faceplate off in there. The numbers on this dial are in better condition. And Ray Melby at Ray's Speedo is not in today. I don't know. Can they unscrew? Does not appear as though they do. Why? They do come off if you twist them while pulling. But this one doesn't have a stop. It's broke. It requires a second pair of needle nose. Okay. There's the face I need. I'll use the best of the two needles. We'll get to that later. No, it's not a very sharp razor blade. Oh, of course. Of course that screw's not going to break loose. Great. Got to take another one apart? I'll tell you what, I ain't going to be as merciful. Isn't this just lovely? I've got to get those out of there. You won't believe what I'm going to do next. That's right. I'm going to install the voltmeter. Ha! Fooled you, didn't I? Now my diameter is correct. I want to clean these all up. What this does, once you take the crimp off of this gauge, that just kind of floats around there. So I'm going to go do a little dabble do you here of the Ultra Geeb in black. Let that set and cure a bit. After a bit of soaking, like it. The click. The odometer. Why, that came out under pressure. Oh, that's because I have it in the vise. Not much pressure, mind you. Now, let's see if we can drop little bits on the gravel beneath the bench. It's a stuck. Oh, it's not a totally stuck. Well, we'll just have to give this a little lubrication. Not much, mind you. Well, here's hoping this will free up. There's a snap ring on this end. And then you can drive this out, but you have to pull that plastic piece out first, which is held in by that retainer, which I imagine is a press fit into here, but you can't push on that plastic to shove it out that way. Not without the what for to ruin the plastic. So I think I'll just let this set and soak. See what happens after that. In the meantime, this is now adhered to the gauge. We have our glass lens, which fits neatly inside of there. And also fits neatly inside of here. The problem is, this does not fit neatly inside of there. And you have a gap between the glass and the gauge. And if it would rattle, I would show you. But it won't, so I can't. And I won't. So what I'm going to do, put the glass in there, put this in here. So if I set this on here like this, will the washers and such be such as to hold this down? No, they will not. Not enough. So if I trim this down to where the glass doesn't flop back and forth, then that's going to give me an eighth of an inch difference underneath there. So that means I have to come up with something to put under here. But I happen to have some of these. Obviously this has to be held down by this one. Why? Look at that. That's quite lovely indeed. I can just cut that in half and use it that way. Woo-hoo-hoo! So when we look into our cheap Buffalo O-ring master kit, that, ooh, it's like, you need the size, you always need the size that's between those two. Or, well, not these two, but whatever two you happen to need. It's always the size between them. Sure, I have to force it in place, which is perfect, because that means it won't move. Now, for centering, that should be about perfect right there. To the outside. Rotate that way just a little bit. Get the top over. Stupid me didn't clean the lens before I stuck it together. That was a test fit. Anyway, yeah, it still needs to move to the outside. Is it repositioning itself after I do that? Oh, right there. That's the one. Oh, you can't see it. Right there. All right, take it apart again. That'll do, pig. There you go. So I will clean all the rest of this prior to its assembly. Whoops. Of the Ultra Geeb in black. wasn't dried up in the end of the tube.
Let's see.
No. Whoops, don't want to do that. Don't want to do that. I need to get this up on something. Why? There's a tool right here. Now, for centering. I know, you thought I was going to flip it over with all the screws on there, didn't you? Where's this at? That's what you want to see. Outside. One moment, please. So I will clean all the rest of this prior to its assembly. What was that? Don't do that.